Hey everybody, did the Lakers kill small ball last season? The NBA, it seemed like, was pushing towards smaller lineups, getting faster, shooting more threes, and then the Lakers came along with their supersized squad and brought home an NBA championship. So, teams are already adjusting this offseason. I'm Trevor Lane for LakersNation.com. Make sure you subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. All right, so the NBA is a copycat league, and we are already seeing teams try to figure out ways to counter the Lakers' big lineups. Let's not forget, though, it's pretty tough to do because teams were going small, not because they just don't like tall people or anything like that. They were going small to get more skill out on the floor. But if you have a player like Anthony Davis, who has the skill of a guard, but happens to be 7 feet tall, that can be pretty difficult to counter. But that said, teams are already trying to do it. In fact, Eric Walden of the Salt Lake Tribune said that in a pre-camp meeting with the media, Dennis Lindsay said the Lakers matchup last season, particularly the game in Salt Lake City, gave the Jazz a clear window into what they were missing defensively, namely the ability to go to big, big lineups, and that caused them to focus on Derek Favors in free agency. So did you get that? The Lakers' success last season changed what the Jazz were planning to do this past offseason in free agency. It forced them to go find another big to try to match up. And they are not the only ones. Look what the Portland Trailblazers did. They tried to run two true center lineups against the Lakers in the playoffs. They tried to run Yusuf Nurkic and Hassan Whiteside to match up. Didn't have the speed to do it. So what did they do? They made a big trade with the Houston Rockets and went and got Robert Covington, rationalizing that Covington's length and quickness would allow him to stick with Anthony Davis a little bit better, whereas Nurkic's size could deal with whatever center the Lakers had there in the middle. Not a bad strategy. Robert Covington is actually a pretty good defender and somebody that the Rockets deployed on Anthony Davis as well. But it's not even just the Western Conference. Look at what the Toronto Raptors did. When they lost Marc Gasol to the Lakers, they went and signed both Alex Len and Aron Baynes, knowing they were gonna need a big body in the middle. The Boston Celtics made sure that they went and got Tristan Thompson. The Clippers. Oh, the Clippers. They went and got Serge Ibaka, hoping that he would be able to match up with Anthony Davis a bit better than, say, Montrezl Harrell, who is now a Laker, would have been able to. So we're seeing strategies change around the league because of what the Lakers just did. And again, that's nothing new. That's not a new concept for the NBA, the idea of trying to counter what the most successful team did or copying what they did. Remember back in the day when Shaq was in purple and gold and teams would employ 7 feet tall people who were usually not all that good at basketball, but just were a big body to throw at Shaquille O'Neal. Now we're seeing similar strategies being used where teams are trying to find another big in order to match up with the Lakers. Now, that being said, if you look at what the Lakers have done with their roster, it looks like while everybody else pivoted to try to catch up with what the Lakers were doing, the Lakers already zagged away and have moved on to something else, because right now the only true center on the roster is Marc Gasol. After that, you've got Montrezl Harrell and Anthony Davis as your other bigs, and neither one of those guys are a true standard back-to-the-basket center. In fact, Gasol isn't even that. He's a three-point shooting big. So just as the Lakers found success employing Dwight Howard, employing JaVale McGee, having them run more of a traditional center-style lineup, as soon as the rest of the league pivoted towards having those big players again, the Lakers have moved on to something else, and I kind of like that. I'm really excited to see how this Lakers lineup comes together and how teams will now adjust to try to counter the three-point shooting that the Lakers now have on the team. But let me know, what do you guys think? Do you like this Lakers roster? Do you think they should have stuck with the big lineup, or did they do the right thing by pivoting away from supersized play just as everybody else turned towards it? Is that going to help them out in the long run? Let me know in the comments down below. And don't forget, follow Lakers Nation across social media at Lakers Nation on Twitter and Facebook, at Lakers Nation Official on Instagram. And if you want to follow me, you can find me at Trevor_Lane on Twitter, at Trevor Lane NBA on Instagram. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.